The playboy of the East, Vijay Mallya, was born to the Indian entrepreneur Vitthal Mallya in 1955. Vitthal Mallya was largely known as the director of United Breweries Group, which he achieved at the age of 23. Following his father's sudden demise, Vijay Mallya became the chairman of the UB Group. He took the charge of the company when the turnover was only 350 crores. Vijay Mallya, however, did not stop with the success of his company in alcoholic beverages alone. He went further to acquire Berger Paints, Pest and Crompton in 1988. He also went on to serve as the chairman of Sanofi India and Bayer Crop Science, among several other companies. Despite being successful in running various companies mentioned earlier, Vijay Mallya's vision did not stop him in trying new venture. The Kingfisher Airline was part of his vision of having a world-class airline travel in India. Having no experience in civil aviation industry, he started this new venture and shifted his entire focus to airline business. Kingfisher Airlines was known for its luxury travel. After its launch in 2005, Kingfisher Airlines soon became synonymous with five-star air travel. Having seen growth in domestic travel, Kingfisher became second largest airline in domestic market with one-fourth of India's shares of domestic travelers. Mallya wanted to expand to international travel, so in order to achieve this, he acquired Air Deccan Company. For this takeover, UB Group paid 550 crores for its stake of 26% in the company.
But soon the decline started. In 2008, Kingfisher Airlines faced a loss of 934 crores. In 2009, the loss was reported at 418 crores. The income from operations declined by 13.6% during this period, and the debt of the airline accumulated to a massive rupees 7,000 crores. The dismal performance of the airline was attributed to an increase in oil prices, recession, acquisition of a financially unsound Deccan airline, and huge operating costs due to lavish facilities that were given by the airlines. But beyond the obvious reasons, it was also due to the poor management by Mallya, where he took actions for his own gain and did not stop operations in spite of making only losses, and allowed shareholders and customers to be under the illusion that the airline was functioning properly. Mallya had accumulated huge debts in terms of loans from banks such as SBI, IDBI, BNB, etc., using his clout despite poor financial performance of the airlines. But soon the banks started asking Mallya to pay back the loans. After this, the case also started getting a lot of media attention. In 2010, banks gave the airline an ultimatum of 9 months to pay back the entire loan that stood around $1 billion. The Income Tax Department froze 11 accounts of the Kingfisher Airlines for non-payment of tax. In 2012, due to the freezing of accounts, Kingfisher had to cancel several of its flights. Kingfisher reduced international operations along with the delay in staff salaries. The Revenue Department of India threatened to take Kingfisher Airlines to court over alleged tax evasion, claiming the company had not deposited taxes it collected from the travelers. The airlines had a total debt of around 7,500 crores to a consortium of 17 banks that was led by the State Bank of India. The lender gives the airline 2 weeks to come up with a plan to improve operations. Then the unpaid staff of the airlines protested in Delhi, Mumbai and other airports, and almost all of Kingfisher's flights from all stations were cancelled as engineers did not certify the planes to fly. A non-bailable warrant was issued against Mallya and four other directors for non-appearance in cases related to the bouncing of checks and non-payments. The Director General for Civil Aviation asked the carrier to clear all dues, including pending salary of the employees, before seeking the license renewal. The United Bank of India declared Mallya and three directors of Kingfisher Airline as willful defaulters. Banks moved to the Supreme Court to ban Mallya's overseas travel, but Mallya left for UK on March 2, 2016, escaping the authorities.
Reasons for the downfall of Kingfisher Airlines. Kingfisher was marred by poor corporate governance since its inception. Mallya used to behave like Richard Branson of Virgin Group. He floated airlines as a gift to his son. Both father and son lacked experience in airlines and had an ineffective board of directors. They ran the airlines at their whims and fancies. Even though the board has a diverse group of people, but they still lacked the experience and knowledge required to fulfill the duties, and also there was no CEO continued for a span of even 1 year at Kingfisher Airlines, and there were frequent changes at the top level management. One of the other things was faulty business strategy. The airline was launched as an economy class with food and entertainment system, but later the focus was shifted to low cost air traveling, which made the travelers confused and they lost their interest in the brand. Malia thought by providing more facility, he'll be able to attract more travelers. However, it was in contradiction to the very core low-cost operating structure and philosophy of Deccan. The Deccan brand was bought under the parent brand name and introduced as Kingfisher Red. This led to the blurring of the brand, and there was hardly any distinction between the full services and low-cost brand. Both branches looked similar and had a similar service. Kingfisher Red became neither full service nor low cost. The other reasons for downfall was the misuse of power. The primary responsibility that arises with power is the responsibility not to misuse such power. In 2010, Malia was selected to be an MP. He used this position for his personal use to add himself in the Civil Aviation Committee. He did so to speed up the approval of FDI into the aviation sector. Malia took advantage of access to parliament to discuss the possibility of convincing banks to settle with Kingfisher Airlines. The finance minister claims to have denied his request as it was not made according to formal protocols. Immediately after this, Malia fled the country.
Probe by the Serious Fraud Investigation Office in India found that corporate ethics were compromised in the merger between Kingfisher Airlines and Deccan Aviation Limited. Kingfisher Airlines had created 3 new departments in the airline to avoid paying capital gains tax. In addition, a non-compete fee of Rs. 30 crore was paid to the owner of Deccan Aviation, Captain Gopinath, which was not disclosed to the shareholders. Apart from this, Malia's financial model was faulty based on pledging one company or the other from the UB Group as a guarantee or collateral. Funds through equity were not raised in April 2008 when Kingfisher was merged with Air Deccan as Kingfisher's stock were high and its debt levels were still low at the time. Raising debts domestically for the airlines industry with low operating profits is a counterproductive and risky proposition. Thus, Kingfisher had heavy losses, default in servicing the loan, and failure to pay salary and government dues became a recurring phenomenon.
They say they have a watertight case against you, sir.
That is for the judge to decide.
But sir, they've also said that...
Morning.